Hi, my name is Brad Jolly, and I'm an applications engineer here at Keysight Technologies. In this video, I will discuss measuring power of IoT device batteries with the Keysight X8712.
When you are designing or validating an IoT device, you want to try to get the longest possible battery life. And in order to do that, you really need to get good understanding of what is consuming the charge in your device, in the battery in particular. So what we're going to do today is talk about the Keysight event-based power analysis software, which is a terrific tool for analyzing the current consumption of an IoT device. It's very simple to use. You simply connect to the instrument by typing in its VESA string, and you can see that the heart of the VESA string is basically just the IP address of the instrument. And you simply say connect, and you'll see that I'm already connected to the instrument. And at this point, you just specify how many samples you want to take. So in this case, I'm going to do, let's say, 10,000 samples at a time interval of, say, 70 microseconds. And then I specify I want 3.3 volts of voltage, and I want to limit the current to protect the device under test, limit the current to 50 milliamps. I want to enable the RF power detector on channel 2. And that's really all I need to do. If I wanted to, I could go ahead and specify trigger parameters to trigger on a rising or falling edge. But in this case, we're just going to do a simple single trigger, which is a very easy thing to do. And we can just click on the acquire button there to acquire the data. Now you'll notice here it says that it's taking 10,000 samples at 70 microseconds per, which means that the time span for acquisition is 700 milliseconds. It's already acquired all that data at this point, and now it's simply transferring that data over the local area network to my local PC here, and you can see it's now arrived. And I've got the graph of the current waveform up here. I've also got the RF waveform up here. We'll talk about that in future videos. And I've also got all these different charts down here, and I can simply click on these different charts to enable or disable them as I desire. Now, one of the neat features of this program is the ability to show what they call zones. And I can divide up my current waveform into 10 different zones, evenly spaced between the lowest and highest parts of the current waveform. And I don't have to choose 10. I can change that number if I want to. If I only want 7 zones, I can do that. And all I have to do is click Analyze to see how it looks with 7 zones. And again, we'll talk about that in future videos. But for right now, I just wanted you to see how easy it is to configure the instrument and acquire data. Thank you for watching.